Hey guys, it is Sabo here, and I am back with another video. And today, I'm with acting legend Smalls from The Sandlot. And today, I'm going to be doing a quick interview. So without any further ado, let's get this interview started. So you were so young, and you were starring in a brand new, and at the time, it wasn't known yet, but it became a very popular movie. Where did you live? Did you go to school? And were your parents with you?
I lived at the time. I just moved from the Bronx to New Jersey. My parents were with me. But when we did the film, only my mom came with me.
Okay. Now, the movie was filmed in Salt Lake City, Utah. Is The Sandlot still there? And have you ever been back to any of the set locations where the film was shot?
Yes. The Sandlot is still there. They kept it up. Kids actually play ball
The
Sandlot. Yeah. And I went back. We all went back for the 25th anniversary.
That's
and we
really
had about 4,000 people at The Sandlot. And we watched the movie there. It was super cool.
So along with all those people that went there, you and your castmates have reunited at card shows and conventions, just like this one.
Mm-hmm.
What is it like when you all get back together?
Oh, it's crazy. We're back to being 11 years old again. No, really, because we were all really good friends, and we had a really good camaraderie. So when we all get back together, it's we don't miss a beat. It's really cool. It's awesome.
I don't know if you'd be considered really good friends because, you know, you're killing me, Smalls.
Oh.
As because a timeless phrase said countlessly by both young people like me and older people like my father. The movie debuted in 1993. I say it regularly when things don't go my way. My father says it quite a bit to me all the time. What is it like being associated with that quote? And do you find it amusing after 25 plus years?
I used to hate it when I was young. I didn't like it. Because it was always kind of like, you know, when other kids at school, you know, they tried to get at me, it was something they would say, you know,
yeah,
before like a fight. But after 20 years, 25 years, I love it. I really embrace it. It's really cool. Now, if I shut off my son's Fortnite and make him go to bed, I hear him say it. And I'm like, you can't say that. You don't get to say that. But I get a kick out of it now. I think it's a lot of fun.
So you have had several acting credits just apart from The Sandlot. You've shared the screen with legendary actors, James Earl Jones, Sean Penn, and Tim Robbins, to name a few. What did you learn from being around them? And are there any particular stories or experiences that stand out to you?
Well, it was, Sean Penn was always one of my idols, and the fact that I got to work on a film with him where he won his first Academy Award,
yeah,
is probably the coolest thing I've done. And I just, what I learned from all those guys is, you know, just, they were all kind of normal people, you know, there's, you know,
yeah,
you know, they worked, they did their job, they were nice, they're just normal people. I think that's what I learned, is everybody's the same.
Yeah.
In a way.
So now it's time for the final segment of the interview, and it's called Quick Pitch. So it's just a couple really quick questions. You just answer one sentence or less.
Okay.
So what is your favorite movie that you have not acted in?
Raging Bull.
What is your all-time favorite TV show?
The Golden Girls.
Who is your favorite actor or actress?
Of all time?
Yeah.
Dustin Hoffman.
Who is your favorite musician or musical group?
Eddie Vedder.
What is your favorite food?
Lasagna.
What is your favorite car that you have owned?
A Dodge Daytona that I wrecked. Yeah, it was my favorite.
If there was one actor you could work with, who would it be?
Gary Oldman.
All right, that's it.
Dude, you rock.
Thank you so much for doing this.
Man. You're really cool. Thank you.
All right. Well, anyways, that concludes today's video. So peace out, Sabonators.
That's fun.